Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to discuss on the topic metric space. So let us begin our topic. So first of all, you have to know what is metric space. Metric space is nothing but a distance function. You have to know that it is a distance function d from x cross x to r. We are defining a function d from x cross x to r. So before proceeding, we have to know that d is what? It's a distance function from x cross x to r. So let us proceed. Let x be a non-empty set. A metric on x is a real valued function d x cross x to r which satisfies the following conditions. So there are some conditions which we have to when it will satisfy, then we will say that xd is a metric space. First is d x comma y is greater than 0. Obviously, if you take a non-empty set x and say, let us consider x comma y are two points, then obviously distance between these two points is always greater than or equal to 0. This is the first condition. Second condition is d x comma y is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to y. So second condition is d x comma y will be 0 if and only if x is equal to y. Yes, this is also obvious. So if this x and y are the same point, then x and y are the same point, then distance between this function will be 0. And the third condition is distance between d of x comma y is equal to d of y comma x. Here also the same thing. If you consider this distance as l, d of x comma y equal to l, then obviously d of y comma x is also l. Distance between x comma y is always less than equal to distance between x comma z plus distance between z comma y. For all x and y, z belongs to x. And this is called triangular inequality, which is very much important. So if you consider x and we take two point x comma y and the third point z, and let us consider this as a triangle, then if we want to go from x comma y, we can go in two possible ways. We have to go from x comma z. We have to move from x comma z to x to z, then z to y. In this way, we can go from x to y. If we want to move from x to y, then first we have to go from x to z, then z to y. Yes, and this distance will be always less than dx comma z plus dz comma y. So from x to z plus z to y, if we move in this way, we can move from x to y, and this distance, this x comma y, will be always less than dx comma z plus this. That is, one side of a triangle is always less than, will be always, also saying other language, that if we want to move from, say, Nogaon to Guwahati, then we can go from Nogaon to Tezpur, then Tezpur to Guwahati, and this route will be always greater than direct Nogaon to Guwahati. This route will be always greater than Nogaon to Tezpur route plus Tezpur to Guwahati. And this we call triangular inequality. These are the four conditions which we have to satisfy. And if this satisfies, then we can say XD is a metric space. then we will say that X is a metric space if all these four conditions satisfy. Now let me show you an example, then you will get a clear picture. Now it will be very clear as you solve the example. It is already said that this function is a metric space. Now let's prove it. So we have to satisfy the four conditions. That is, first is dx comma greater than equal to 0. Second is d comma x comma y equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to y. Third condition is we have to fulfill is dx comma y equal to dy comma x, that is symmetry. And fourth condition is triangular inequality, dx comma y is less than dx comma z plus dz comma y. So let's go with the first condition is dx comma y equal to, what is dx comma y? Modulus of x comma y. Modulus of x comma y, and this we know, this function cannot be negative, so this is obviously greater than equal to 0. And the second condition is, the second is dx comma y equal to y. We have to prove the second condition, dx comma y. Now dx comma y equal to 0 implies x comma y equal to 0 implies x comma y whole square equal to 0 implies x comma y equal to 0 implies x equal minus y x equal to y, sorry. Now if you repeat the if you make a step upward, then you can see that if x implies is if x equal to y, this implies that x minus y equal to 0, x minus y whole square equal to 0, modulus of x minus y equal to 0, and we can prove that d of x comma y equal to 0. Hence we can say that if dxy equal to 0, if and only if x is equal to y. Now we are going to prove the third condition. Now taking minus sign common, we can say this. Now this is equal to this. Sorry. Now this is equal to dy comma x. So hence we have proved the symmetry, and this is very important. You have to see for dx comma y. Dx comma y equal to what we have, can write x minus y. It's given already. Now if you take the third point, I was saying that z. You can write plus minus z is the same thing. Now z, this, take it in two sides. Now this side will be always greater than the left hand side. Implies you can say dx comma y will be less than z comma y. Now this will be dxz plus dzy. Hence our triangular inequality is also satisfied. Now as you have seen, dxy has satisfied all the four conditions. Now you can clearly say this is a metric space. Now you can clearly say that D has satisfied all the four conditions. That are the first condition, second condition, third condition, fourth condition, all the conditions are satisfied. Now you can clearly say D is referred to as the Eisele metric on R. Another example, let xd be any metric space, show that the function d1 defined by d1 xy equal to dxy by 1 plus dxy is a metric on x. Solution, here it is given that xd is a metric space. At first, that means my x, that is symmetricity, that is symmetricity. And the fourth condition is d x comma y will be less than equal to dx comma z plus d z comma y, that is triangular inequality. Now given that these are the four condition that xd is a metric space, if xd is a metric space, then these are the four condition which will satisfy. Now from question, in this question it is given d1 xy equal to dxy by 1 plus dxy. Now we have to prove that d1 is a metric on x. What is given? dx y is very simple. At first, dx comma y, first condition, equal to dx comma y by 1 plus dx comma y. Now second condition is d1x comma y equal to dx comma y by 1 plus dx comma y. Since dx is a metric space, so we can write dy comma x from the third condition. So our first condition d1x comma y greater than equal to 0 is fulfilled. Now second condition is we have to show that d1x comma y is equal to 0 when if and only if x equal to y. So for that, first we are assuming d1x equal to 0. This implies dx comma y by 1 plus dx by y equal to 0 as d1x comma y equal to dx comma y by 1 plus dx comma y. This is given. Implies dx comma y equal to 0. So when this is 0, this implies that x is equal to y as it's a metric space. So we can show that when we reverse the process, we can show that d1 x y equal to 0 when x is equal to y. So our second condition is also fulfilled. Now to show the third condition, that is of symmetry, we are taking dxy by definition as simple dxy equal to 1 by d 1 plus dxy. Now as d is a metric space, so we can write dxy equal to dy by x by dy by x. Now we can write this as d1y by x. So our symmetricity condition is also fulfilled. Now we are going to prove that is the important one, triangular inequality. For triangular inequality, we know dxy will be less than dxz plus dzy as d is a metric space. So both sides we are adding 1. This will not affect our inequality sign. Now if you reciprocate it, this will become our aim is to prove d1xy will be less than equal to d1x comma z plus d1z comma y. This is our aim. We have to prove this. Now if you multiply minus 1 both sides, then it will change our inequality sign from this, from greater than equal to less than equal to. Now again add 1 both to this both sides. So from the last step we got 1 plus minus 1 by dx, 1 by dx is less than equal to 1 plus minus 1 x comma z plus d z comma y. Now if we take the LCM and solve it, we will get dx by y equal to 1, dx by y is less than equal to dx comma z plus d z comma y. This minus 1, both the side will be cancelled out. and finally we got our LHS set, and this will be D1 x comma y. Now we have to make it this set. Now this will be, it's very simple. D z comma y. Now from the last step we got D1 x comma y will be less than equal to, now break this into two parts. Z comma y plus d z comma y 1 plus d x comma z plus d z comma y. Now see, this will be very important. We are taking out this term. We will eliminate this term, and we'll see that it will not change our inequality sign. As if we remove, if we make the denominator small by eliminating this term, then obviously this term is greater than this term. So in that way you can see the whole term will be bigger than this term. We have shown it satisfies the triangular equality. So we can say that D1 is a metric on X, or X minus D1, or X. We have shown that D1 is a metric on X, or X D1 is a metric space. So friends, if you watch the video till end, so please like it and do subscribe my channel. Thank you.